Welcome back, cartography fans. In our last episode, we learned how to measure distances on our map, and now we learn how to tell the exact location on Earth of any point on the map. Scaled appropriately, the Earth's surface is smoother than a billiard ball, and all we need are two dimensions to describe our position on this nearly smooth surface. The traditional method uses latitude and longitude. To understand these numbers, recall that the Earth is spinning upon an axis that runs through the north and south poles. This gives us two cardinal points, the poles, and one cardinal line, the equator. We can measure one dimension of our surface relative to these fixed points and line. Imagine an indestructible and fairly attractive person at the center of the Earth. If this person were to measure an angle between that cardinal line of the equator and any point on the surface of the Earth, they would be measuring the latitude, how far north or south of the equator that position is. The equator is zero, and the largest value of latitude possible is 90 degrees, reached at the poles. Longitude is not so easy to visualize. These are lines that all pass through both poles and thus encircle the full circumference of the Earth. This is one way to remember longitude from latitude. Only the 0 degree latitude line, the equator, encircles the full circumference of the Earth. Any latitude other than zero is smaller than the full Earth's circumference. Longitude lines are always long, going around the full circumference through both poles. Longitude. Okay, but unlike latitude, which has the definite cardinal points and line of the poles and the equator to measure relative to, longitude has no such cardinal points. We arbitrarily have to agree as a human society where to put this cardinal line. And historically, it has been all over the globe, through St. Petersburg, through Paris, through Washington, D.C., but finally settling upon a line that goes through Greenwich, England in 1884, when 25 nations delegates met in Washington, D.C. with President Chester A. Arthur and agreed that the fact that two-thirds of all ships were using Greenwich as the reference meridian already was enough to kind of make it the official zero-degree longitude line. France abstained and continued to use Paris for a few decades, but eventually conformed. One of us. Unlike latitude, measured as the angle north or south of the equator with a maximum value of 90 degrees, longitude is measured as the angle east or west of the Greenwich prime meridian, and increases to the opposite side of the globe at 180 degrees. So if you're wondering if you're looking at a value of latitude or longitude, you are guaranteed that if the number is over 90, then it's longitude, not latitude. A quick note on the divisions used to measure angles in latitude and longitude. We use what is known as the sexagesimal system, which is a base 60 instead of base 10. We start with a complete circle. And this, it was determined in ancient times, should be measured in 360 degrees. Because the year was basically 360 days to complete its seasonal circle, with a 5-day festival period at the end to recreate time. But anyways, 360 is also one of the most divisible numbers you can think of. What goes into 360 evenly? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 15, 18, 20, 24, 30, 36, 40, 45, 60, 72, 90, 120, 180, 360. A total of 24 divisors. This makes 360 what mathematicians call a highly composite number, or a superior highly composite number, or a colossally abundant number, or a refractorable number, or a five smooth number. Most basically, it is the smallest number divisible by every natural number from 1 to 10, with the exception of 7. And it's about the number of days in the year, so the circle is 360 degrees. But each degree of that circle is then broken down into 60ths of a degree, and each 60th of a degree is called a minute. Each minute of arc is broken down into 60ths of a minute, which we call a second of arc. 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in a degree, and 360 degrees in a full circle. Okay, now look at the northwest corner of our map, and note the numbers written there. Low on the left, we have 39 degrees, 52 with a single tick mark, which represents minutes of arc, and 30 with two tick marks, which represents seconds of arc. Above that, we see 105 degrees, 15 minutes, and 0 seconds. The 39 degree number lines up even with the upper horizontal border, which should be a latitude line. They run from east to west. And the 105 degree number is evenly over the left vertical border, which should be a longitude line that go from north to south. Latitude lines go east-west, longitude lines go north-south, okay? Now, another way to know which is to realize that a latitude can never be over 90 degrees, but a longitude can reach up to 180 degrees. Our location is 39 degrees, 52 minutes, 30 seconds, and they don't tell you whether it's north or south, but we assume you know that you're north of the equator. And 105 degrees, 15 minutes, 0 seconds west of the prime meridian. We don't see any indication of west, but hey, the USGS has it easy. Every map under its purview is west of England, even Hawaii at near 160 degrees west longitude. Now move over to the northeast corner of the map, and as before, the horizontal latitude is still 39 degrees, 52 minutes, and 30 seconds. And we said this upper boundary should be a latitude line, and we indeed have just gone across the same latitude. The longitude should be different, though, and reads 105 degrees, 7 minutes, 30 seconds. We have changed longitude across the map, and the difference is 7.5 minutes of arc. Hey, look at what we saw under the title of the map. This is a 7.5 minute series. Does it work both ways? Well, let's see. If we go down the right side of the map, we see the longitude is now unchanged value, and the latitude has gone from 39 degrees, 52 minutes, 30 seconds to 39 degrees, 45 minutes even. Another 7.5 minutes of arc difference. The designation of this map as a 7.5 minute series means that it covers 7.5 minutes of latitude from top to bottom, and 7.5 minutes of arc from left to right. Latitude lines are pretty much evenly spaced between each other, but longitude lines are farthest spaced at the equator and closest at the poles. For this reason, you can approximately guess the latitude of a minute series map by looking at its basic shape. Maps closer to the equator take on more of a square shape, whereas maps closer to the poles have a vertically stretched look. Finding any location on the map is a matter of following grid lines up and over, and using a ruler to get a distance between successive degree markers. And using a bit of basic math, you can zero in on your location. Come back next time, and we're going to see another way to find your location on a USGS map.